So today PUBG is getting an update and the servers are still under maintenance. So when I tried to turn it on, the servers were under maintenance. So update is 8.3, which is about to be live. I don't know how much time, I did not see the time, but it will be live. So there's a lot of new features in the update and a lot of things. So let's start by the top feature. So they are adding new fairies to your angle. For those who are wondering about the new dogs on your angle, for all the versions we added in last update, your ship has come in. Two new fairies will now carry passengers across the version. Further angle to from Python and Bag Basic. So there are four fairies that make round trips throughout the game. For those of you not feeling lucky enough to go across the bridge, four fairies have been added to your angle. Fairies will allow players to vote and there will be two route sets between your angles, Mill and Sankara. It's from that place to the other side where you can go to Sukhna Country Base, and the second place is Nova Repnoi. I guess the ferry will start from somewhere Ferry Pier to Nova Rep, because both have docks as I remember, but if there's something else they added, because I did not go on the map too much, so I don't know about that. Now there's this new jammer pack they're adding, which will stop you from getting from taking damage from blue zone, which is very I guess it's important, but it's not a very good thing to be added, because you can see right here the jammer pack allows to prevent blue zone damage for a short time at the expense of a level 3 backspace. That means you cannot add you have to throw many of your things, something like that. That's what I think right now, because if it takes level 3 backpack space, then you can pretty much guess that you have to throw your backpack away. And then after it's for a short time. They have not mentioned the time here, so when the time ends, I guess this turns into a backpack, and that is what I read from here. And the jammer will function as a regular dungeon. Then this is the gameplay updates that they'll bring in, and in general they added decoy to Karrack in as well, and training mode, and Miramars. Okay, Miramar stacks are not destructible, just like Wrangles, where you can run over them with the cars. Added Painan bootcamp to TDM. Okay, bootcamp I guess okay, but Painan, I've played Painan, not RTDM kind of map according to me. Added additional natural cover in the form of trees and rocks outside bootcamp. Okay, north and west both sides. Since recent sound improvement to car and escape, receive feedback that our volume are too loud, we've heard your feedback and lower the volume. That's good. And destructible wooden shacks have been re-added to your angle. This will be replaced with concrete shacks in update to 8.2 due to technical issues. Okay, they were replaced and they're now back to destructible wooden shacks now. I remember them, where they were located near shacks most of the time, and you could run over them with any sort of car and they'd break. And I don't know about car 98, but SKS, yeah, it was very loud. Even with a suppressor, it was like you're shooting the gun without a suppressor, and it was so loud that you could hear it from at least up 400-500 meter easily, except any other gun. So that's a thing. Now Sandhawk loot truck. Added jammer pack to the loot pool. Okay, greatly reduce the number of level 3 helmet and ghillie suit shop. Nice. And limited number of duplicate items from loot truck to prevent situation where excess loot at the same time is dropped from one loot truck. That's good, because it was kind of overpowered, because you'd see everyone having a ghillie most of the times in a match, and a level 3 helmet, you had shot them and they have a level 3 helmet. So it's a great update according to what I think right now. Assist system, this is just where in the system, you know, you damage somebody and it will show up in assists. It's just, that's not anything really important. Teammate combat indicator. So what I'm thinking right now is like, this is some kind of PUBG Mobile kind of update where you'd see, I'm not saying about you'd see footsteps or you'd see where the shots are coming from, but according to what I've read from here, you will see visual indicators for your squad for when your squad mates are under attack. That means you're going to see them either on the map or on the, you know, on your screen somewhere because of 3D teammates. So that makes the game a bit too easy because if your teammate is under attack, the previous way of this was when your teammate was under attack, you would you will have to personally see and hear the sound from it. What I think that this will show you where this fires are coming from, but it's not like that, then I guess it's pretty much cool. If it's not going to show on. Okay, so the notification on display was expected to you. Now bot AI improvement. Yeah, the bots were really really stupid. They would shoot you from over 150 meters sometime. I've seen them doing that to me and it's nothing cool, but sometimes the bot will, you know, just run right across from your screen like he didn't see you, and that's insane. So I guess now the main thing is right here, this one, M4 sound adjustment, because the M4 sounded really weird. So the sound is a crucial factor for PUBG. They just change the sound of M4 again. I don't know what right now, but with the above mentioned, we've made additional M4 changes to M4 sound. You have new changes are more to your liking, we'll be monitoring, blah, 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 blah. But they've just changed it. So when rank you're trying to search matches in rank mode, if this was the old PUBG, you'd find a match instantly, almost instantly, and you can find the match in TPP almost instantly right now as well. But if you're trying to search in rank mode, then I guess sometime it takes time. So you can they've bring in this practice and training mode while you're searching for the match if it takes more than 30 seconds. So that's kind of cool feature. But if you're okay, we'll see in game. It's a cool feature. Performance and optimization. Now this is the main thing about this, because some people they face weird glitches sometimes. They have problems in game, and like when I downloaded this game, I had no problem with this game, but the next day there was random stuttering in the game and everything was all right. My RAM usage was same, and still. So reduce the chance of hitching and stuttering to occur while the game is spawning items. So what I think right now is they're adding they will load the items, or they will pre-load the items when you enter the game, which is kind of, I guess, if you have the game on SSD, a good thing, but in a hard disk, I don't know about that. We expect the movement will also resolve most cases of item not being displayed upon landing, in cases where throwing a melee weapon can result in the projectile visually stuttering. Character spawning optimization reduced instances of hitching or stuttering which could occur during the loading of multiple vehicles of tier 1. Optimize shadow animation when exiting vehicles. Optimize the cost of world particle effect to AS potential overloss, which could cause a decrease in performance, and optimized the rendering pipeline to improve performance. Now they write many things. It's a big update. You can see the scroll goes a long way right now, but still sometimes, you know, I don't believe most of the things they say, but okay. I will see. Custom matches, loop rock icons, and new items, the remote, okay. General player head up UI displayed in the general mode has been slightly optimized for better experience. Like it was, if you watch some of the tournaments, the esport tournament that ended, I guess 2 days ago or yesterday, I don't remember, but you could see big ass names on their head, so it's good. And then added jammer pack again. That's for the esports things. We don't care about them, right? And what is this? Social features. In an effort to make our friend system easier to use and a better place for all things social, we revamped the system into a brand new social page. Here you can see your friend list, people you've recently played with, etc. Improved the friend list, pop art, blessing it with a new full screen social page. Social page can be accessed by clicking social widget in the lower right corner of the lobby. They've made a new page instead of you going to the bottom of your screen and then clicking and that right side panel popping out, that overlay. Okay, so UX UI updates, skins and okay, ranks, insignias have been aligned on the lobby screen. Indicator message now will display in situation where connectivity issues are preventing up to. That's just some glitches that may have happened. I don't know about them. So skins, we do not care about skins. Who cares about skins if it's not your favorite streamer skins, I guess. So now these are all skins. So bug fixes. Now fix the excessive reverb when firing the arm. Yup, I agree, because when I used the arm yesterday and when I shot someone, or even if I missed, when I shot the arm and I fired the arm, it would just, I can't explain that, but it was really really bad. Okay, fix the Canon G8 reverb sound not playing when shooting outdoors. So the reverb is just another word for, you know, recoil kind of thing, the kickback of the gun. So sometimes the Canon G8 would not make any sound, and if there was a suppressor on it, it would, it's alright, but if there's no suppressor on it, then it was a bit glitchy, I agree. Fix an issue with player would could use melee weapons inside the starting plane in what? Okay, I don't know. Fix a visual issue with the scorpion where the bolt moved too far forward in single firing. I never faced that. Fix a visual issue. Let me see. Fix the way into force play abnormally in NDS. I did not see any glitches except the first two. So I don't know about them, I'm not talking about them, okay? Now, world, fix the issue where boats could spawn on top of wooden docks on Irfrangle. Nice, I don't know. Fix an issue where characters could take damage while jumping continuously a different set of trains on the game. Yep, I've seen this. And even when the train was not moving, I'd take damage. I know about that. Fixed misaligned text on the match history screen. Sometimes that would happen. You'll kill somebody and it would pop so late, or it would be somewhere else on the screen. Fix an issue which omitted helmet level information of some helmet levels. Okay. Fix the issue where new makeup skins are misaligned in the customized screens, like they are some kind of warfighters, so you cannot apply skins on your face, on character's face. Greatly mitigated an issue where squad mates were not displaying the team list UI. Yeah, that happened yesterday with my teammate. He could not see my name. We were in same game. He was asking me that I did not enter the match. I was the first one to enter the match. And when we were all looting together, he shot me twice because he thought I was the enemy, because I had no sign of being the teammate. I had no icon up above my head, or I was not shown in his UI, in his teammate UI. So that's a pretty bad glitch. I thought it happened for the first time with somebody, but now after reading this, I guess it happened to most of the people. Sound, fix the issue where menu navigation errors did not have any sound effects. Maybe sometimes, I don't know. Skins and items. graphics is strange, texture displayed when equipping. Okay, we don't care about skins as I said. Replay, fix the issue where the top 4 UI displayed even when jumping back on timeline. Fix the issue where the top 4 UI was empty when skipping forward on the time. I don't know, replay system has been added. Replay files from previous updates are now unable to be used. Okay, so that goes for the update. That is pretty much all that is going to be in this update. I mean, there's not a very very big, it's a big update, but it's not like a huge update which would just change PUBG. I guess PUBG is already not what it was when we used to love PUBG, but still they're making updates so that players won't get bored and we can wait, we can see where PUBG is going. So thanks for watching, like, share and subscribe, and I will try to make a custom match video and show you most of the things after the update is live. So stay tuned and thanks for watching.